The next few years should be interesting when it comes to the new wide-body freighters being offered by the two big plane makers. In the summer of 2021, Airbus announced the launch of its A350 freighter program, or A350F. Likely having developed the idea for a few months, Boeing responded by announcing the launch of a 777X freighter program at the end of January 2022. With lower demand among customers for freighters when compared to their passenger equivalents, the market has been and will continue to be competitive. So, which next-generation wide-body freighter is the better choice? Let's try to answer this question in today's video. Let's first start with the basics and compare the technical specifications of these aircraft. Without passenger capacities and passenger-based features, there seem to be fewer factors to consider, but let's examine some key metrics. The length of the Airbus A350 is 232 feet 4 inches, or 70.8 meters, compared to 232 feet 6 inches, or 70.9 meters for the 777X freighter. The 777X's wingspan of 235 feet and 7 inches, or 71.8 meters, is noticeably longer than the 212 feet 5 inches, or 64.75 meter wingspan of the A350F. When it comes to the size of the main cargo door, Airbus's freighter door measures 4.19 meters, or 165 inches, by 3.71 meters, or 146.5 inches. While Boeing's main door is 3.72 meters, or 146.5 inches, by 3.15 meters, or 124 inches. The maximum takeoff weight for the A350F is stated to be 319 tons, while Boeing has yet to disclose a figure for this. The 777X freighter has a payload of 118.2 tons compared to just 109 tons for the A350. As you can see, the 777X freighter can also carry one more pallet on its main deck and one more in its lower hold. This increased weight and capacity comes at a cost to the aircraft's range, as the 777X freighter's maximum range is 4,410 nautical miles or 8,167 kilometers. This is nearly 300 nautical miles less than the 4,700 nautical miles, or 8,700 kilometers, listed by Airbus. Powering these aircraft are a pair of Rolls-Royce Trent XWB-97 engines on the A350 and General Electric GE9X power plants on the 777X. The Rolls-Royce engines have a thrust of 97,000 pound-force, while it's 110,000 pound-force for each GE9X engine. The target entry into service for the A350 freighter is 2025, 2 years sooner than the 2027 target for the 777X freighter. As you can see from these figures, the aircraft are quite similarly sized. The A350F is based on the A350-1000 platform, while the 777X freighter is based on the yet-to-enter-service 777-8. Airbus has been aggressively marketing its A350F over its Boeing competitors. In marketing material on the manufacturer's website, the European plane maker hasn't been at all shy about comparing it to competing Boeing products, mainly the 777F and the 747F. However, Airbus does make at least one direct comparison with the 777-8F, saying, "As for the proposed 777-8F, while the current estimates suggest that it could offer 6% more volume and 7 tons more payload than the A350F, this would come with a hefty burden of at least 32 additional metric tons, or 32,000 kilograms, of takeoff weight, Airbus's initial estimate, which increases fuel burn, CO2 emissions, and airport charges." The A350's composite body, with over 70% of its airframe comprised of advanced materials, is indeed something worth considering, as it will equate to a lighter airframe with lower fuel burn. On the other side, the Boeing 777X retains a more conventional aluminium fuselage. While composite materials make for a lighter aircraft, could it also lead to more issues? We know that a composite fuselage has resulted in some problems for both Airbus and Boeing when it comes to paint adhesion and surface degradation. Hopefully, this will be less of an issue by the time the A350F enters service. However, as the world's first freighter with a composite airframe, Airbus is entering new territory, and we'll just have to wait and see if this presents any complications for Airbus or its customers. Airbus also said that, by its own calculations, its A350F will provide operators, quote, around 65 more revenue days due to less maintenance downtime versus the proposed 777-8F over 16 years, thanks to the A350F's clean sheet advanced materials and well-integrated systems. Airbus has also been quite vocal about its extra-large main cargo door, calling it the, quote, largest cargo door on the market. While a February 2022 Airbus fact sheet put this door's width at 3.81 meters or 150 inches, its main A350F page now has this figure set at 4.19 meters or 165 inches, which is about 12% wider. With so much time between now and entry into service, we'll have to keep an eye out for any more details adjusted by the two plane makers. So, with both jets being on the market at the same time for over a year now, how has the aviation industry reacted thus far to these offerings from Boeing and Airbus? Let's look at order figures as of January 2022. According to Airbus's official orders and deliveries records, the plane maker currently has orders for 39 airframes, as you can see from this chart here. Thus far, Boeing has racked up orders from 5 different customers for a total of 58 airframes, as you can see here. Thus, at the time of this video's production, it looks like Boeing is ahead in sales. Of course, these programs are still in their infancy, and we would expect more orders to come in the months and years to come. Back in November 2022, Simple Flying reported that Middle Eastern carrier Kuwait Airways was reportedly ready to introduce cargo flights into its operations. According to CH Aviation, the airline was in talks to convert its order for 5 A350-900 passenger aircraft into 2 passenger variants and 3 A350 freighters. Unfortunately, in looking at aircraft sales, we're unable to provide an accurate comparison of prices. While we can say that the 777-8 has a list price of $410.2 million, the last official published list pricing from Airbus came out in 2018, some 5 years ago. We can tell you, however, that Axon Aviation Group lists the new price for an A350-1000 at $355.7 million, although it's difficult to know if these figures are up to date. For what it's worth, Airbus's 2018 list price for an A350-1000 was $366.5 million. So, are there any other factors to consider? It looks like the A350F could be a cheaper aircraft that is available sooner. Additionally, it looks to have a larger main cargo door and lower fuel burn with a greater range. Despite having a payload that is several tons lower than the 777-8F, these facts and figures point to the Airbus aircraft being a more attractive product that might even be cheaper. Indeed, with the A350F coming out 2 years in advance of the 777-8F, operators hoping to expand their operations and increase their capacity sooner than later could turn to Airbus. With the Boeing 777-8F having more capacity and a lower operating cost per ton as its key advantages, customers may simply make their decision based on fleet commonality. After all, maintenance and supply chains, as well as pilot training and type ratings, all have an impact on operations. Interestingly, when looking at customer orders so far, many carriers already operate both Airbus A350 and Boeing 777 passenger or cargo aircraft, and if considering fleet commonality, could have gone either way. Here are some examples. Air France operates both the A350 and 777 passenger variants, but also has a pair of 777Fs. Etihad Airways also operates both A350 and 777 passenger variants, as well as 5 777Fs. Lufthansa flies the A350 for its passenger operations, but has 11 777Fs in its cargo division. Ethiopian Airlines operates both A350 and 777 passenger variants, as well as 9 777Fs. Perhaps one notable exception is Azerbaijani cargo operator Silkway West, which ordered two A350Fs and two 777-8Fs. The carrier currently operates an all-Boeing 747 freighter fleet, including the 747-400F and 747-8F. Of course, it's also worth noting that although Qatar Airways operates passenger versions of both the Airbus A350 and Boeing 777, as well as the 777F, its current feud with Airbus essentially rules out the A350F as a possibility. Earlier in 2021, prior to the ongoing paint saga becoming a bitter legal battle, airline CEO Al Bakr had expressed strong interest in the A350F, stating, "Definitely, we'll be at the front of the queue. We will soon be replacing our current fleet of freighters, and we would want to replace it with the best freighter that is available. We would be very happy to be the launch customer of the new variant." Ultimately, the two products look fairly comparable. Because of this, customers may examine other factors unrelated to the performance specifications of each jet, with timeline and commonality appearing to be the more notable factors for consideration. But what do you think of these two aircraft? If you were shopping for some new wide-body freighters, which aircraft type would you choose? Share your thoughts by leaving a comment. Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com.